In this video, we will talk about adding surfaces and props to our scene. We've already seen a terrain surface being added automatically whenever roads form an enclosed area, but we can also use the surface tool to manually create a surface. Select the surface tool, then right-click to create control points that bound the existing scene, and a terrain surface will automatically be created. We can easily change the surface by dragging different material onto it. For example, let's change the type of grass being used in the scene. When adding a surface, you'll notice some visual artifacts with the overpass, because the section of road above the other road is not designated as a bridge span. This can be resolved easily using the Road Construction tool. Select the tool, then select the overpass, and click Auto Assign Bridges. With that, the visual artifacts are resolved and we'll get a confirmation that a bridge span has been added. Prop tools allow us to add assets from the asset library to the scene. There are several prop tools available, but we'll start with the Prop Point tool. As the name suggests, the Prop Point tool allows us to place props, in this case stop signs, at any point desired. With the prop selected, we can right-click on the sidewalks where we want to place the stop sign. Adjust the attributes to ensure the stop sign faces the right direction. To accurately recreate a real-world scene, it may be necessary to add some trees and bushes to the scene. To create a row of trees along the edge of a road, for example, we can use the prop span tool. Select the prop span tool, select the road, then drag the prop onto the curve to line the road with trees. We can use the attributes pane to adjust the spacing of the props. In this case, let's make the trees a little more spread out by increasing the spacing. Finally, the prop polygon tool is extremely useful for filling an area with a type of prop, like bushes or shrubs. For example, let's fill in this area by selecting the Prop Polygon tool, selecting a type of bush, then creating a polygon with our desired shape. Thank you for watching.